Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another Shopify customization video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can add Shopify selected variant images on the product page. If you don't know what is Shopify selected variant images meaning if you have a product page and you have multiple colors on for that product and every single color have different images, Shopify doesn't have the feature where it's going to basically show only those images which are selected. So let's suppose you have a product with colors red, white, or black. When you open up the product page, it's going to display images for all of those colors. Ideally, what you want to have is when someone click on black color variant, it should only show the images which are associated with the black color variant. If someone clicks on white color, it should only show the images which are associated with the white color image. Shopify recently released in their summer edition 2025, the new Horizon theme. But still that feature is missing on the Shopify functionality. And that's why we are creating this tutorial for you. And we have created a completely separate playlist for that feature. As you can see on my screen, we have this for 15.2.0, which is for Dawn theme. This is for Dawn theme 15.1.0, Dawn theme 14.0.0, Dawn theme 13.0.0, 11. So these are all of the older version which I have created. If you're still using the older version, you can follow these videos. And this is the playlist link, which I'll add in the description. So you don't have to find the video within the channel, but you can still find it out just by clicking on the search and the search icon within the channel. So make sure to check out the videos which I have created previously. And still, if you're using Dawn, I would suggest to move on to the Horizon theme because they have added a lot of cool features which you should definitely have on your store. And now let me show you what you will be learning in this tutorial. So this is the product where you can see we have all of the images showing up, and it has, so I'm gonna hide this bar here so you can see it properly. You can see that we have red, pink, and vanilla color, but all of the colors are showing up, all of the images of all of the colors are showing up on the product page. And when we change the variant, it's only gonna change the main image and rest of the images will still be showing up. So it's not properly functioning. It should work. And similarly, if I click on this third color, it's just going to change this main image. It is not going to change these rest of the images. But after following this tutorial, I'm gonna give you a tip and trick in the code. After that, you will have it looking like this. So as you can see, we have this red color showing up. And when I switch on to the different variant, it's gonna show only that color. But you can see that this is the size chart, which is going to be visible on all of the variants, right? So if I switch to the third color, you can see that only size charts is visible on all of the colors, but only the selected variant images, meaning the selected color, is showing up. So really important feature for all of the stores which are looking to build a new store using the Horizon theme. And when I talk about the Horizon theme, it includes all of the 10 new themes. So basically all of these 10 new themes which Shopify recently released in the summer edition 2025 have the same code base which they are saying Horizon. Okay, now without further ado, let's get into the backend and try to implement that. Okay, so first I am going to my backend of the store, and then what I'm gonna do, I'm going to install a fresh theme. And so Horizon have 10 themes. So if you Google Shopify themes and go to Shopify themes and then search for the theme and filter it for the free theme, you can see there are total 23 themes where we have these new latest one is all from the Horizon code base, meaning they are all using the same code base, which is from the main theme called Horizon. This is the one. And all of these theme like Saver, Tinker, Dwell, Vessel, Fabric, like I don't know how to pronounce that. This is also using the same code base. So they are basically different in styling. You can do that with the customized theme, customizing the style, but the code base is completely the same. So it's the code which I'm telling you guys, it's gonna work completely fine on all of these latest theme. And again, here's the Dawn Spotlight Raid, which is the old code base from the Dawn code base, right? Okay, so let's install a fresh theme. What I'm gonna show you guys how you can implement that. It's pretty simple, super easy. you can just do it within a minute, less than a minute maybe. Okay, I have reached the theme limit, so I'm gonna delete some of the themes. So let's delete this one. Let's delete this one as well. And I'm gonna install a fresh theme. Let's do the horizon. We're currently using it in Duel, right? I'm gonna install this horizon and show you guys how it works. So let's do that. Okay, it's being installed. And while this is being installed, guys, if you are new to Shopify and want your Shopify store for just $1 a month, there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your store for just $1 a month. Shopify keep changing their offer, so make sure to always use the link which is in the description to sign up for the new Shopify store. Okay, guys, and one more thing. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. I've created a lot of tutorials and some of the tutorials which I'm going to show you guys. So this is for the Dawn theme. If you're still using the Dawn theme and you're looking to add transparent header, make sure to subscribe to the channel and make sure to check out the other tutorials which I have created. We have this different sections. We have a lot of features which we have created just for you guys. On top of that, we have our own app by the name of Big Bulk Discount. This is an app which can help you add volume discount on your Shopify store. So currently Shopify doesn't have the feature to add in tier discount or volume discount on your store, which you can add using this app. And this app is available for 7-day free trial. So just install it and see if it helps you boost your sale. Otherwise, simply install, right? No need to pay anything. Just install, test it completely for free for 7 days. And if it works, keep using that. Otherwise, simply uninstall. You can Google it by the name of Big Bulk Discount, or the link will be in the description. Okay, guys, so our theme has been installed and I'm going to publish that. Click on publish and then publish again. Perfect. And now if I preview this product page on, still opening up the older theme, I'm going to preview that. And open up that product, which is this one. Here you can see we have all of the colors showing up, which we don't want, right? We want only the specific color images which are selected. If I select pink, it just changed the first image but doesn't work on the rest of the images. Okay, let's figure that out. Click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Guys, before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. In all of the customization code tutorials which I create in this channel, I always suggest you guys to have a duplicate version of your theme in case you mess up anything. Please don't blame me in the comments that I didn't tell you to have a duplicate. There is no guarantee that it is going to work completely fine on your theme, because you might have different apps, you might have different code customization already installed on your theme. So I don't know what you have on your theme, right? So make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. Okay, so in the code editor, we will be going to this file, which is product-information.liquid. This is the blog post which you find in the YouTube video description. And all you have to do is just add this code. Okay, so I'm gonna search this file on the code editor. Here's the file. And on top of that file, I am going to add this whole code. So what this code does, it basically goes to this file. So if I open that up in a new window and add in .js, so that is the data available by Shopify, which gives you the complete details of all of the variant. Let's suppose here we have this options. And if I position values red, pink, vanilla. So that's what this code is doing. It's basically checking this from this JS file and comparing the color for whatever you have selected. And whenever you select any of the color, it is basically going to hide the rest of the images which are not selected. So that's how the functionality is working. The code is really big, but you can go to ChatGPT or any of the LLM to define this code for you if you want more understanding of the code, right? So I'm gonna simply paste the code from this article here and then I'm gonna click save. And now if I go to this product, it is going to basically filter those images by matching the alt text. So basically it is working due to the alt text. You can see it's now showing only the pink color. Red is showing only the red color. Vanilla is showing only the vanilla color. But how it is telling that this specific color is selected, it is basically matching the alt text of the image. And how you can do that, let me show you. So if I'm going to go to the product backend, let's open that in a new tab. You're not only supposed to add in the code, you're also supposed to add in the alt text within the image of your product page. So let's open up. This one here. And here you can see we have these images, but each image is having the same value as this one here. So if I open up this image and check out the alt text, you can see I have added it red. Now, previously when I created this tutorial with the alt text functionality, a lot of you guys have commented out that this is not good for SEO and it is going to deteriorate our SEO. But this time what I have done is like, you can just add the color within the end of the actual alt text. So you can have anything like woman, top, cotton, fabric, whatever you wanna add into alt text. And at the end or anywhere within the alt text, just add in the value of your variant color, just like red. So it is red color and I added that, and when I click on save, it is still going to basically do the same thing. So I'm gonna do the same thing for all of the images. So let's do, you can see that I have all of this text here and at the end I have the value of the color. Similarly, if I go to the next image, you can see that I have this additional text in the alt text, but at the end of that I have this red color showing up. And I have done this for all of the images. As you can see here, pink, it's telling the color, which is pink. Right? So always make sure to include this alt text and to the image which you want to display on all of the colors, you can simply add in the all color values. Like you want to display it on red, pink and vanilla, so you'll just add in the alt text with all of these three values and you can add whatever you want to add and it will still going to work completely fine. So if I click on save and preview this product, it is going to work completely fine. So, okay, it's done. So here you can see that we have our, what do you call it? Size chart is showing up. And if we switch to pink, gonna display the pink image, vanilla. So that how it works. And I'm gonna change the style as well for that. So let's go and change the go to product, page template. And in that, I am gonna go to the product media. And then here, I'm gonna select carousel. Okay. Carousel or pagination portrait. What was the layout? Here we go. So here is the pagination of thumbnails, right? And let's click on save. Let's go to refresh the page. And now we have these three images showing up. with the size chart. And here we have this pink. Here we have this red. So make sure to update the alt text after adding the code in the product-information.liquid. If you are having any issues implementing the tutorial, let me know in the comments below. I'll try to get to it as soon as possible. Until next video, hasta la vista, baby.